In the past few years, YouTube original movies have become something that Red subscribers have become used to. Is it new? No, not really. Movies based on YouTube personalities have been going on since 2010. However, now YouTube is producing these films. This has made me ask myself, can YouTubers really make good movies? Now, I'm not talking about those YouTuber cameos in big feature films like Dan and Phil in Big Hero 6 or Troy Sivan in X-Men Origins Wolverine. I'm talking about these YouTubers leading an entire film on their own. Some have tried, most have failed. Now, when looking at these movies, there are two categories they fall into. There's movies that are actually produced by a studio, and YouTube originals. The movies that are made by studios are such critical hits like Not Cool by Shane Dawson, Fred the Movie by Lucas Cruikshank, the Smosh movie made by Smosh. Now clearly these movies all have something in common. They're bad. You can be a fan of these movies, all the power to you, but they're not really groundbreaking works. On the other side of the spectrum, you have the YouTube original movies. This includes such hits as The Thinning, Ghostmates, and We Love You. YouTube really pushed through these movies and put advertisements for them everywhere. The problem still occurred that these weren't very good films. And it really seemed like YouTubers couldn't make good movies. From how I see it, these YouTube Center movies are kind of like video game movies. You've already invested your time into these YouTubers just like a video game. So why would you want an hour and a half shortened down version of their content? This brings up the question of why aren't these movies good? Well, that's what I'm here to answer. Let's first look at the movies produced by the studios and see what the fundamental problem is. Not Cool. This film centers around a group of high school friends reuniting over their Thanksgiving break during college. It's a very basic movie, but also very much just Shane Dawson being Shane Dawson in a movie. I know Shane has openly made fun of this movie, so it's not like he thinks it's a masterpiece or anything. This movie basically just turns into Shane Dawson being himself. Smosh the Movie. Well, this movie is literally about Anthony and Ian getting stuck in YouTube. Again, another movie that's plot is basically, this person is popular on YouTube, so let's make an hour and a half version of what they do every week. Fred the Movie. This movie is the most bare bones of all the YouTube Center movies. Fred was a huge part of YouTube and at one point was the most subscribed channel. It only made sense to give him a movie, and then two more. However, this movie ended up being more of, well, let's make a movie about Fred because it's easy. Fred screams, he's an easy character to make a movie about, and the kids like him. Noticing a theme here? These movies are basically a copy and paste of this person is popular on YouTube, so let's make a movie about them, and we'll figure it out from there. The problem that this creates is it just creates a glorified hour and a half movie about this YouTuber, if they were just a regular guy or girl. It just doesn't work. We know these YouTubers, and we've watched them, so why do we need an hour and a half version and condensed version of their videos? This is one thing I can at least credit the YouTube Red movies on. They didn't just make movies about the YouTubers being YouTubers. The Thinning, Ghostmates, and We Love You are all incredibly generic stories, but they put the YouTubers in different environments. Unfortunately, the stories are bland, and they aren't able to rely on the YouTube star as much. Now, this whole discussion brings me to the question, is there a movie starring YouTubers that's actually good? Yes, there is. The little movie called Brigsby Bear. There's magic and wonders and mysteries. Is Brigsby Bear a good movie? Yes. Is Brigsby Bear a creative movie? Yes. Did Brigsby Bear finally try something different? Yes. If you can't tell, I really, really, really love Brigsby Bear. Brigsby Bear is a movie made by Kyle Mooney and Dave McCary. Their YouTube fame came from their comedy sketch group, Good Neighbor Stuff. The group was comprised of Beck Bennett, Kyle Mooney, Nick Rutherford, and the filmmaker Dave McCary. However, Kyle is the member I want to really focus on. Other than Good Neighbor stuff, Kyle also made a name for himself on his own channel, very cleverly named Kyle. On this channel, Kyle showed a wide range of characters he had created. Characters like Chris and Todd, and also had his very famous awkward interview segments. This popularity has paved his career in joining SNL and becoming a full-time cast member and also writing for shows like Nathan For You. Kyle has seen tremendous success, but it all started from YouTube and now leads to Brigsby Bear. Now, I don't want to talk about much plot when it comes to Brigsby Bear because I don't want to spoil it for anyone. However, something I want to talk about is how this movie differs from other YouTuber-heavy films. The first thing that helps this movie is the uniqueness of it. It's weird, but in the best ways. It would have been really easy for Kyle just to make a movie about one of his recurring characters, something like Chris being in high school or his awkward interviewer finally making it big time. But he didn't. He tried something different and unique. Brigsby Bear focuses on James Pope, a totally new and creative character. He's very much like Kyle with his personality, but he's a character the audience doesn't already know. If you haven't seen Brigsby Bear, I strongly suggest giving it a watch. It's definitely worth it. Now, the major argument against Brigsby Bear is that it shouldn't be put on the same level as these other movies, because it's actually made through Hollywood. But I don't really understand this argument, because Fred had the same budget as Brigsby Bear, not to mention that Fred also got two sequels after it. This results in the only real difference between the Fred movie and Brigsby Bear is, I'm sorry if you're the biggest Fred fan in the world, but Brigsby Bear is actually good. With all this being said, I feel like the only way you can look at all these categories of movies is to look at three different spectrums. The first of these I like to call Hollywooding YouTube. These movies include The Smosh Movie, The Fred Movie, and Not Cool. These films very much rely on the success of the YouTuber, and they just end up being a glorified sketch that has more production put into it. The second are the YouTube originals. These include Ghostmate, The Thinning, and We Love You. These movies rely on the star presence, but don't really make an effort in story. They seem really original on the surface, but they just end up being pretty bland. The only positive is that they at least do something new with the YouTuber. I mean, it's pretty great that Logan Paul isn't just vlogging during all the thinning. The final category I like to call, well, it's pretty simple. I like to call it Brigsby Bear. And it includes one movie, Brigsby Bear. This movie literally throws out both of the ways these categories make movies. Does that take something that Kyle has done on YouTube and really use it to push the movie? No. Does it sacrifice the story to have a big name star in it? No. This movie breaks all the rules that YouTube can't seem to figure out. When the focus starts at the characters and then lets the story evolve from it, it works. This movie proves this platform doesn't have to be hinged on what the creators are known for, but lets them evolve into something new. This movie is better than we as the audience deserve. It's something new. It's something fresh. It transcends YouTube. It's Brigsby Bear.